Good morning, Apollo Baptist Church. It's Monday morning. It is June 22nd. And this morning I want us to look at Psalm 126. More here than we'll ever be able to experience in a few minutes, but it is wonderful truth that I want us to meditate on just for a little bit. Psalm 126 makes it very clear that God is the source of our joy, and He has brought us great joy and wants to bring us even more. It speaks to every phase of our life. The beginning three verses seems to indicate that some joy comes relatively quickly. The latter three verses indicate that some joy takes a long, long time. It's kind of like having a baby. That joy comes quickly. Raising a child takes a long, long time. Going to school can be a very exciting moment. Finishing school can take a long, long time. Getting a job can be a tremendous celebration. Working that job for many, many years and retiring seems to take an eternity and a tremendous amount of energy. Nonetheless, there's joy that comes quickly. There's joy that takes a long, long time. All joy is really a result of God working in our life. The first three verses talk about how God brought them back out of captivity. When the Lord brought back the captive ones of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue with joyful shouting. Then they said to the nations, "The Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We are glad." Praise God for those. We'll take all of them we can. The next three verses, "Restore our fortunes, O Lord, as the streams in the south." Their streams were like our streams. We have rivers here in the Phoenix area that are dry as dust. So did they. And so he says, the streams of the south, restore. Oh, they need to flow again. Your life is like that. "Those who sow in tears shall reap with joyful shouting. He who goes to and fro weeping, carrying his bag of seed, shall indeed come again with a shout of joy, bringing his sheaves with him." Oh, well, kind of like the joy of a farmer. You have to sow seed. You have to wait. You have to carry the seed bag and toil and work and wait and pray. It seems to take forever. I'd never make a good farmer. I'm in too big a hurry. I plant a seed and then I dig it up to see if it's ready to come forth. You know, some joy just takes a long time, and it is characterized by those who sow in tears. That's hard work. That's times of difficulty. That's times that's not easy. "Shall reap with joyful shouting." God will see us through. God is there. But not all joy comes quick, and not all joy comes easy. You know, as the care pastor of Apollo Baptist Church, one of my areas of ministry is helping people with grief. Grief is a monster. And grief is harder than probably any emotion that we ever deal with. The dealings of loss is so hard. We're getting ready to start a next semester of Grief Share, a ministry designed to help people go through the dealings of grief. And I think of that when I see this, those who sow in tears, grieving is a difficult time, shall reap with joyful shouting. Not a surface kind of joy, a deep-centered kind of joy. Grief Share is a Christ-centered, Bible-focused discipleship ministry for the purpose of getting us through difficult times with God, experiencing Him. Not a facade, very real, but very full of Christ. Someone rightly said one time, grief is something you'll never get over, but if you let Him, God will get you through. I like that. It's not hopeless, it's realistic. We're not trying to get over grief, but we want to join God in getting us through our grief. Our next session of Grief Share is this coming Sunday, June 28th, 5 in the evening. It'll be in the Fellowship Center. We will be social distancing. We will do all of the precautionary measures. Everything is sanitized. And we would love for you to be part of it if that is something that God wants you to be in at this time. You can call the church office. You can make them aware of it. I will give you a call. You can get a hold of me. That would be no problem at all. Or you can, I believe there's going to be on this email a button for you to click on, and you would be able to simply write your name and your contact information, and we will be able to get a hold of you. But I hope that you will allow God to work you through this time, no matter if it's grief or what, but there is joy that comes out of the long haul. Joy that you walk with God through when you can't see the result. A farmer cannot see the crop when he plants the seed, but he does it because he knows God is faithful. I pray that all of us will experience God's great joy in our lives today.